So another update of what's going on here with the tintypes, photography, and my travels. So right now, I am still in Augusta, Georgia, working on the tintype process and working on getting everything up to specs and up to a product that I feel comfortable showing and a product that I feel comfortable selling. So what I've been doing is been doing a few sessions of my own, taking pictures of family members, and I started getting the hang of it. It started coming up pretty good, but there's some hiccups in there. There's some stuff in there that I just don't know what I'm doing wrong. And I reached out to a few people that have been doing tintype through Instagram, and they've been tremendous and giving me so much help and guiding me in what the possibilities of what I'm doing wrong. I've gotten to a point where I feel comfortable with the exposure. I feel comfortable using the camera. It's more of making the plates clean and making them look the way that I want. Here I'll show you a few of the tintypes that I've had issues with, and you can see what's going on. And then again, this one here is a picture of my cousin Nikki that I'm pretty happy with, and I'm pretty happy with that came out. It's composed just slightly off. The lighting in the back is slightly off, but I feel this is a success, and it's letting me know that I'm on the right path and I know what I'm doing. So with learning how to do all that and also getting better at it, I've booked a few places. I've booked a rodeo in Augusta, no, not Augusta, in Grovetown, Georgia. There's rodeo coming up the second week or the first week of April. I believe it's April 8th, and I'll have to go check that again, but I believe it's April 8th. And then I've booked a barbershop / tattoo shop, an old timey one that seems to go perfect with these photos. And I believe it'll blend really well with the types of haircuts that they're giving their clients and the type of clients that are coming in. So I'm setting up there. April 14th and 15th. And then from there, I'm probably going to start heading towards North Carolina, up into the Appalachian Mountains. There's some breweries out there. I have a friend out there that has invited me to come stay up in his area. I also have family up there, so that should be really cool. Also, I've picked up a few jobs here doing some photography stuff. There was one that was called the Crawl with Us. It's a bar crawl, and they have events all over the country. And I just found them on Craigslist, signed up, and got a response pretty quickly that they're looking for somebody in Augusta to shoot the St. Patrick's Day bar crawl. A couple hours, good money for a couple hours, just going. My job was to show up and take pictures of people at check-in, basically get a group shot of people right after they check in with a backdrop or some kind of backdrop I find that's most appropriate. That happened to be a St. Patrick's Day backdrop there that worked out perfectly. So yeah, there's a video that I'll put in right with this that you can see.
All right, so here's one of the jobs I picked up. Shooting pictures of people at a pub crawl, at a backdrop, and just as they come in and get checked in, I take the photo. Pretty good for a couple hours, pretty good pay. Hopefully I can work with this company all over the country.
Ready, 1, 2. That's been going on. I have some other shoots, like a pre-prom shoot that a woman was looking for on Facebook, and I just reached out to her and she was all excited, so gonna do that. So yeah, things are picking up. There's some photography jobs that happen here and there. Also, the podcast is starting to heat up as well. The last one was with my friend Clarence that does these amazing skateboard portraits, or I'm sorry, skateboarder portraits. They're all kind of the same style, but unique in each their own. So definitely go check that out. Clarence Klingenbeil. Get it wrong all the time. I should be able to know this. I have some German heritage to me, or some German family in me. I should be able to say these words pretty good, but I can't say the English words that good. So yeah, go check out Clarence Klingenbeil. His stuff is incredible. There's a few more podcasts that are in the queue. One of them that I'm really excited about, I've learned not to, not spill the beans before it happens, but hopefully there's one big one that I feel will be a pretty popular one that I'm sure everybody in the Boston area will love to hear, especially if you're a sports fan. So yeah, that's going on, and I'll have some more videos up. It's been kind of slow right now with a lot of brainstorming, working, trying to get more jobs, more leads, and working, you know, basically on the computer. But yeah, like I said, I'll have more videos up of the tintype process and me getting better at it, hopefully. So stay tuned.